Hello everybody, Rikopa here, and welcome back to Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone for the PC. Last time, we've completed the Herbology class, we've learned the Incendio spell, and we've also got to knock Malfoy off his broomstick. And by doing that, we got a position in the Quidditch team. Yep, you heard me right. Only at Hogwarts you get to... You got to be rewarded for breaking the rules. Yeah. There's like a huge explanation to it. I'm sure all of you Harry Potter fans know what it is, but they didn't explain anything here in the game. But anyway, that was fun. It's been a while since I've last played, but here I am again. And I remember that Doxy over there. Yep, I remember. Oh, there's two. There's two. Anyway, so Hagrid has asked us to go to his hut. He has something to tell us. I wonder what it is. And do you know how in the books, they just like, when they go to Hagrid's hut, they just go down a slope. And here you have this whole forest area you have to go. You have to break down whole trees by using Flipendo spell. Anyway, oh my god, here they come, get out of here. Okay, oh my god, there's another one, three in a row, wow. Okay, let me take a look at the Folio Magi real quick. Okay, so we're missing one here. Okay, so we're almost done with page 3. That's how I measure how long the game is, by the Folio Magi. All right, so we have about halfway done. We'll see. Still have a little bit to go. But anyway, let's go. So there's a little more here. Let's grab more beans. We already have 295 beans. That's like a lot for Fred and George when we meet them. Ah, so here we have two options now. Well, first of all, let's grab this frog so he doesn't interrupt me. Let's use the Flipendo here to break down this tree. So, yeah, down here, there's actually nothing, as far as I know, as far as I remember. Well, it doesn't hurt to check, but I don't think, Oh, see, there's something over there, though. And it's a treasure chest. Ah, it's an opening. Okay, so I was about to say that we have two ways to go. Two ways to choose. But they all end up in the same place. So since we know there's a secret here, let's go this way first. There it is. Okay, now, should I try to go on the other side? I should, right? Yeah, just in case there's also an opening on the other side, even though I don't think so, because that's not how it works. That's not how it works, like, this is the room, and this is the space they've developed. There we go. Oh, man. Like I said last video, I recently watched the... One of the lead developers of this game giving an interview about how they did this game. And it is so amazing. I suggest you guys go watch it. It's very easy to find. Like the making of Harry Potter, the game, super easy to find. It's so good. It's like, oh man, it back then, 2001, you didn't have anything to work with. And I'm not just talking about Harry Potter. I'm talking about like video games in general. Especially PC gaming, because there was not like too much to go through in terms of graphics and whatnot. So it's really cool to see that everything worked out well for them with this game. So I'm not sure we're supposed to go down yet. Yeah, there's no way to go down yet. What's there? Or have we been down there before? We probably already have been down there. But anyway, back when I was a kid, I've played this game, as you all know, and I've also played the Chamber of Secrets one, which apparently was released by the same developers as this one. And it's that one is even better than this one. I mean, it makes sense, right? You are improving how to develop a game, like you're learning. Excuse me? Did I just incendiate you all? I think those three guys here... Yeah, there you go, you see? Oh, oh my god, I'm getting hurt. I'm getting hurt in the cutscene. Anyway, remember last video when I told you guys that there was like a set of these snails, snail-like creatures that you have to use Flipendo in order to a secret appear? These are them. So now I have to go upstairs. But before we go up here. So anyway, what was I talking about? I was talking about the development of this game. The second game, you guys will see when I play it on my channel. It is much more fluid. I feel like all the animations are so fluid. Everything is so much better. I love if Hogwarts feels a little bit more alive than this one. Anyway, where am I going? I'm going further and further away from Hogwarts hut. But it's okay. It's all in the good name of exploring, right? All in the good name of exploring. Is there a bean? Oh, look at that sneaky bean trying to hide from me. Where does this lead? Oh, that's so magical! Oh, this has gotta be a wizard card, right? It has to be. Come on. Haha! And I know exactly who that is just by looking at that small image right there. Let's see. Spinning. Explosion. So, one of my friends told me that they love this spinning I do. Now I have to do it every time, okay? I did it once, and they love it, so... gotta do it, gotta please your viewers. But anyway, here we have number 35, Bowman Wright, from 1492 to 1560, famous for developing the Golden Snitch. You know the Golden Snitch? I don't know if you guys can exactly see it, but it's like this little ball here they use on Quidditch. If you catch the little snitch, the Golden Snitch, you win the game, basically. Like, it gives you a lot of points. And the match ends immediately. So, yeah, so this was this guy here. There's a lot of information on him nowadays. He was the creator of the Golden Snitch, but when Quidditch first started, they didn't use the Golden Snitch. Before this guy created it, they used an actual real animal. I think it's called the Golden Snidget, which is not very creative, but whatever. And they actually used to use those in the matches. That's crazy, right? Jesus Christ, like, animal abuse much? Anyway, we've completed the third page. Like I said, sometimes they don't go in order. So it's not like we were missing Mr. Wright here. But now, let's go. Let's continue onwards to Hagrid's hut. I'll meet you guys when I'm close to that secret passage to the upstairs. Okay, we're back. And there's Hagrid's hut over there. Try not to go over there, otherwise you will trigger the cutscene. And... Let's go to the secret place first. Okay. That's a nice little hut, I think. I wouldn't like to live in it, but for those who do like to live in huts, that's a nice little hut. Okay, what do we have here? I think it's just more memes. Yep. Oh, no! We have a wizard card here. Hope it doesn't get stuck. All right, glitching walls, hello, spinning, explosion. Okay, let's see who this is. Oh, Oh my God, I remember this. I remember. They skip a whole page. They do that on purpose. I'm pretty sure they do that on purpose. They do that to make you go, "Oh my God, I missed four wizard cards." No, you didn't. Two pages, in fact, number four and number five. Let's go see Herpo the Fowl, ancient Greek, first known creator of the basilisk. So, the basilisk, everybody, I don't need to explain a basilisk, right? Everybody knows what a basilisk is. And this guy was the first one to create a basilisk, like, actually, the first one to actually breed the basilisk species. Why did he do that? I don't know. He's probably blind himself. I have no idea why somebody would do that. Anyway, let's leave Mr. Herpo the Fowl here. I mean, what would you expect from somebody named Herpo the Fowl? All right. Can we just jump over here? I'm just gonna jump over here. All right, Hagrid, you wanted me. Here I am. What do you have to tell me?
Hurry, over here. Come along then, I've something to show you now.
He's feeding the pigs.
By the way, congratulations on making the Quidditch team. Word travels fast round Hogwarts.
Thank you. I didn't do any tryouts. It was pure luck.
Welcome to my home, Harry. It's small, but still roomier than your cupboard under the stairs, eh? Now I can show you what I wanted to talk to you about. It's a dragon's egg, Harry, but it's our secret, mind you. The egg is in a very delicate stage. I can't leave it here alone, but I need some fire seeds to give it that last burst of heat to make it hatch. Harry, can you fetch me some fire seeds? I grow them in caves out in the garden. I need you to collect as many fire seeds as you can find. Careful, though, they're spitting fire and the seeds are hot. Let them cool down before you pick them up. Off you go then.
And now we have the very first filler side quest story of this game. We have to go collect some fire seeds for Hagrid. I mean, what? Fire seeds? Come on. Really? Anyway, so that's the secret Hagrid was harboring. He's breeding a dragon egg. And can we go to his bathroom here? But you know what? For Hagrid, for that hunk of man over there, we do everything. Do anything he wants. So, yeah, we have a goat here. I don't think there's anything for us to do here. Can I just go up? I can go back inside, right? So yeah, Hagrid makes a good point though. I was saying before that I wouldn't want to live in a hut like this, but for somebody who's lived under the stairs, in a cupboard under the stairs for 10 years of his life, it's much better, right? Okay, so one of these. Okay, so I think I remember. I remember. I remember. So. We've come from here. Not exactly, but they make us think. No? Well, I don't know. Whatever. Yeah, I think they make us think that we came from here. We didn't, though, but they make us think like that. And then we'll go here, and once we're done, we will emerge over there. Yep. If my memory doesn't fail me, that's how it goes. Anyway, I do not like this part of the game. I guess because growing up, I knew that it was complete filler. I was like, oh, you almost got me. You almost got me. But anyway, I think growing up, I knew, like, there's no fetch quest in the books. There's no fetch quest in the movie. Why are you making me do this? No, I was one of those annoying little kids that are like, I want everything to be perfect, just like the book. But nowadays, I understand that that's not how you make a game, man. Imagine how boring this game would be if there was not like some little side quest like this one over here. So yeah, I'm glad that the people actually thought about including some side quests in the game. But anyway, Okay, so I don't remember how many whatchamacallit, seeds, fire seeds we have to collect. Look at that beautiful, beautiful 2001 computer graphics waterfall. Amazing. So yeah, I don't know how many seeds I have to collect, but I'm gonna try to collect them all as usual. Do not wanna miss anything in this game. I see a doxy over there. She's coming for me. Okay, so usually you just follow the arrows, right? Not this time. Not this time. Not in the Harry Potter world. In the Harry Potter world, if there's a sign saying go this way, you really want to go the opposite way. Really want to do that. I mean, if I was a student at Hogwarts, dude, I would be exploring every single place. Like, study? Pshaw. I will not be doing that. I will be exploring everything I could. Is there a secret here? Hello? Harry? Please don't tell me you're glitched. Harry! Oh my god. Okay. That was painful. Oh my god. The pain continues. Jesus. All I want is go back up the stairs. I just want to see if there's a secret here. All that pain for nothing. Now that you've explored everything, now you can go collect. Now you can go the correct way, shall we say? Dude, this atmosphere is just amazing. Oh my god, they recover fast. Please leave me alone. Okay. Look, it's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. Trust me when I say though that if you grow up playing computer games like I did, I didn't have a console. I had a Nintendo. I have a Super Nintendo. Can I grab that doxy from here? Cannot. I had a Super Nintendo growing up, but I was not really that much of a fan of Nintendo games for some reason or another. So. And as soon as I was able to have a computer as a kid, I was playing every single game available. Everything that was there, I probably played back in those times. Anyway, let me try to focus here. So I have two ways to go. I think if I remember correctly, in order to open this gate, you have to go all the way over there and try to find another lever and then backtrack. I think, because I don't think we can use this anymore. Yeah. So let's try to remember that this passage is here. Oh, maybe it's here, actually. Is it? I don't know. Well, this is definitely a secret, though. So let's continue keeping on this path. Oh, here we go. Oh, actually, never mind. I just appeared on the opposite side. And now it's open. Okay. That's very simple. Let's proceed to seed collecting. That sounds weird, but okay. That's disgusting, actually. Why did I say that? Okay. I faintly remember a secret over here somewhere. I think is if I drop down here. Problem is, can I go back up though? If I drop down here? I'm gonna try. And I was correct. And we all even have a wizard card here with one of my favorite wizards of all time. Who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be? Ba-ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Spinny, spinny, spinny. Explosion. And this one is, let's go back. Morgan Le Fay. Le Fay? Le Fay? Morgan Le Fay. Medieval, dates unknown. King Arthur's half-sister. Dark sorceress. Enemy of Merlin. And that's it. That's all we have on Morgan Le Fay. I mean, it's Morgan Le Fay. It's like it's. She's very famous in Arthurian legend. I've always liked her for some reason. When I was a. So when I was a kid growing up, I used to write a lot. And I used to create a bunch of different stories. And one of my stories, one of the protagonists was Morgan Le Fay. But I didn't know anything about Arthurian legend back there. I just found the name cute. Morgan Le Fay. It was not that it was cute. It was more awesome than cute than anything. Morgan Le Fay. Anyway, can I do this jump? Can I do it? I haven't died a single time in this game. Uh-oh, Indiana Jones. Bum, ba-dum, bum, bum, ba-dum. DMCA copyright. Okay, I've learned my lesson. I cannot sing. Anyway, go forward. Should I go left, right, or straight? The answer, my friends, is always left. That's the answer to everything. Okay. Okay, so now this is interesting. There's a sign here telling us that this is the correct way. So we probably should go straight first. Yeah, there's just a chest over there. Okay. Got all the beans. Okay. Yeah. But here's the funny thing. Oh, it's actually telling me to go this way. Yep. Okay. Let's go this way then. Dude, this is dangerous for an 11-year-old. Even if you do have magic. All right.
That must be a fire seed plant. Hagrid told me to stay away from the hot seeds.
Okay. Stay away from the hot seeds. And what he means by that is he casts Flipendo spell, and you don't go collecting it yet. You wait for it to cool down. You see everything's like glistening, glittering. Yeah, now it's cooled down and now you can collect it. If you try to collect it before, you get hurt, you get damaged. But anyway, one of the reasons I also dislike this part is because of how long it takes. You can bet your ass that today's video is just gonna be this. Maybe not even complete. It's just too long, it's a huge part of the game. And I just playing this for the first time, I just wanted to go back to Hogwarts. I want to explore the castle more. I didn't want to explore the outside that much. So I was very sad. Anyway, we're up here now. Boy, I've always felt like this part of the game was a burden. And that ruined me for every forest location in Harry Potter games. Forever. Every time I was like, oh, do I have to go outside? I was like, oh my god. Bad memories, bad flashbacks, and everything. Wait, I have one more plant here. Fire plant. Okay. Are you cool down? They're cool down. They always release tree seeds, so. Okay. For some reason, I also, when I was playing this for the first time a long time ago, doing this part of the game, it always reminded me of Cyndaquil. Yep, you heard me right. Freaking Cyndaquil, I don't know why. it's definitely something fire related, right? Of course. But then why? Why did this part always remind me of Cyndaquil? Oh, maybe it's because of the shape of the tree. Oh, maybe that's what it is. I don't know. I used to have a vivid imagination when I was a kid. Oh yeah. Well, I didn't plan for this part of the video to be about my childhood. Childhood stories with Recopa. But I think it's a good practice for me to for commentating, because I'm not a huge fan of when Let's Players keep talking about like their lives, games. Like I wanna play the game. I wanna see you play the game. I don't want. Why are you talking about a random fact of your life? You know. But in games like this, especially if it's not blind, then I can totally understand. And as I'm doing this right now, I totally understand. And but it's also a good practice for me, because English is not my first lesson. It's very hard to play, think, commentate, and focus on the game at the same time in another language. So yeah, it's very hard. So everything, and I make a point to always keep talking, otherwise it's just gonna be boring, right? Like if you're looking for a, if you found this video and you were actively looking for a Harry Potter Let's Play, you expect some commentary, right? Otherwise you just put in Harry Potter Philosopher's Stone PC long play or no comment, no commentary or something. You can find easily, you can easily find those. Anyway, new enemy? Or have we met the fire crab before? I don't remember. Oh my god! Oh! Oh! Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Everything is glitching. Oh! Okay. Whew. Alright, and I think in the sequel... Oh! Nope, not the sequel. You have to do this in this game. You have to drop... the fire crab, the poor fire crab, into that hole. And he's down. Can I see him down there? I cannot. Well, I guess I didn't have to drop him down there. But anyway, I did. I'm sorry. Sue me. Ooh. Oh man, it's very hard to see through these bars. Uh-oh, did I just glitch the game? Was the fire crab supposed to open this? Because I see a flipendo mechanism over there. It's probably to open this, but I cannot see... Oh, man, they made this difficult on purpose, didn't they? I cannot see a passage on the other side, though. Oh my god, I seriously hope I'm not missing anything or glitching the game. Because as soon as I collect this book, then if everything's glitched, I won't be able to do this. I won't be able to come back to a previous save. Unless I can, like, not collect. Never mind! The game glitched and forced me to collect the book. Anyway, let's just hope for the best. Like, you have like a secret place over there. It's probably where I need to go. So excuse me, Venomous Tentacula, while I open this secret place. Yeah, this is it. Okay, I was worrying for nothing. But that's just who I am. I really worry about missing stuff in video games. And it gets to a point that if I'm not Let's Playing, of course, if I'm just playing games by myself, I actually load the game. I don't want to miss, like, a single thing. It's a compulsion of mine. Like, if it's there and I miss it, I collect it. That's why I've come to appreciate game developers who put, like, the way forward. Like, this is the way to progress the game. It's right here. It's, like, very obvious. I like that, because that gives me the option to explore everything else before going in that direction, you know? Because it's just so sad when you have, like, you go this way, and then, like, oh, load screen, and now you can go back here. Ever, you just missed a bunch of screens. Motherfucker, why did you do that to me, game? You know, I do not like that feeling at all. If you guys are familiar with point-and-click games adventure, like the likes of Telltale games, before they disbanded. Like, Telltale Games to me was, I love them, right? I love Telltale Games. But it was also a nightmare in that regard, because, oh, I have 15 seeds already. I think that's maximum, probably? Don't know. But anyway, Telltale Games. So, I used to love them. I think I have every single Telltale game that they released at the time. And one thing that I absolutely hated about it was, like, you had stuff to explore, have places to click on, and then the adventure just, like, you don't know, like, you're in a room like this, right? And the order to progress is if you click on this pickaxe right here. But you don't know that playing the game, like, and then you have a bunch of stuff to explore. But if you make your character pick the pickaxe, then they automatically advance the scene. And I'm like, but I have all those objects to explore first. And they also autosave, and that's, I hated that. Like, oh my god. And I was not about to load the entire episode just to explore, like, random objects, you know? Oh man. And then they made it worse going forward. They made it worse by making, like, one of those objects that were optional actually useful in some scenes. God. So they were like, oh, too bad you didn't explore that place, right? And you didn't explore that place enough? Nintendo! So anyway, I'm sure somebody out there understands what I'm talking about. And they also share my frustration. So if you're one of those guys, hi, you're not alone in the world. Okay, I see we have a tree here, but before we collect that, let's go down first, because obviously the way to go is up. I mean straight, it's over there. So let's go this way first, collect this. Probably just beans, yeah, okay. Now let's collect. We do have more seeds then. I wish they actually showed you, like, the counter, so in order for you to not miss any seeds. Like, oh, you have, how much is it now? 16? 17? 18! You have 18 out of 18! So you've collected them all, you don't need to worry anymore. But yeah, some game designers, like, actually know about that, and they make an effort to not include missable stuff in your games anymore, especially if it's an open world game. If you're developing an open world game and you include missable stuff, missable scenes, especially missable collectibles. Oh my god! If you do that, Jesus. You're a bad man. You're a bad developer. Put missing collectibles in an open world game? Dude. Okay, so now I'm in a conundrum, because there's no sign, and I can obviously go down or up, and I do not remember which way that is the way to progress. Let's carefully try to go down first. Because it's also left, you know. I'm gonna stop. People are gonna hate me forever. Oh, but then again, up there we have a gate. I can't see it anymore. As long as there's a way for me to go back, then I'm not that worried. I do not want to go forward too long, though. If it means I'm gonna progress the game. Oh, you know what? I think I just turned around. I think I'm back on the up part. Nope, I'm not. Wait, am I? We'll see. So, if I use this, and this gate opens, and I turn here, aha, I'm right. So if I came here first, I would be met with a locked gate and I would miss some beams. It's okay, that's not the end of the world though, but yeah. Okay, so obviously this way to go. Oh, we still have more beams. I mean, more seeds. Okay. Remember to let them cool down first. 20, 21. What did I tell you guys? This is a long part of the game. Long part of the game. But it's gotta be done. It's gotta be done. Not every single game has short sections, should I say. Oh, never mind. We're here. We've completed it. Hagrid! Daddy! I mean, what? Yeah, remember what I told you guys? We went down there, and we come out here. And they're trying to tell you that this place here is where you came from the first time, right? Yeah, I remember Hagrid feeding the pigs on this left side here. Anyway, we're done! Hagrid!
Great work, Harry! You've collected all the fire seeds I need. Here's a wizard card for you, from my own collection.
Thank you.
Come on inside, Harry. Wipe your feet now.
Ooh, that's interesting now. Did he just reward me with a wizard card because I've collected all seeds? Or does he always reward you with a wizard card? I don't know. I'd like to think it was for my effort, you know, collecting all the seeds. Spinny, 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 magical explosion! I also know who this is. Oh! Uh-oh! Oh my god, please, game, don't tell me I've missed one card. Now I'm actually worried, because I know I told you guys that it doesn't go in order, but... And anyway. Salazar Slytherin. Medieval wizard, dates unknown. Co-founder of Hogwarts, gave his name to one of the four Hogwarts houses. So yeah, so this is Salazar Slytherin. We've had Godric Gryffindor before, and now we have Slytherin. So as usual, like I did with Gryffindor, here's the picture of Slytherin nowadays. Good. I still think this picture though. I still think this picture looks good. It's not bad. It's not bad at all. Like, the cartoonish style of all these wizard cards are very charming. Very charming. I actually like that. Anyway, oh my god. Oh my god. Should I Google it to see if I've missed this card? Well, anyway, I can go back anyway. The door's closed. The gate's closed. So, that ship has sailed. Let's hope for the best that I didn't miss any single wizard card. Whew. Let's go. Glitchy.
Go ahead and put them in the fire, Harry.
The seeds? Oh.
You've done it, Harry. It's hatching.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, lovely. I'll call him Norbert. He's a Norwegian ridgeback, you know. Up you come, my beauty.
He's adorable.
Thanks, Harry. Here, take this flute. It can be used to help some creatures sleep.
Okay.
You'd best get ready for Quidditch now. Should be an exciting game. Slytherin's a tough team, but you'll show them, eh?
I will.
We'd better give Norbert his first feed soon.
Okay, Quidditch match. No time to rest.
Woo! Welcome to Quidditch! I'm your commentator, Lee Jordan! It's Gryffindor versus Slytherin.
The way he says it. Gryffindor versus
Slytherin. The Quidditch pitch has three goals at each end. The chasers throw the quaffle and try to put it through the hoops to score. Watch out for the bludgers. These are charm balls that can knock you off your broomstick. Two beaters of each team try to keep them away. Gryffindor's new team is Harry Potter.
Uh-oh.
It's his to find and catch the golden...
Uh-oh. Lee Jordan's glitching.
no favoritism.
Sorry, miss. Remember, first avoid the bludgers, then find and catch the snitch. The game is over when the snitch is caught. Good luck.
Okay. Whew, let's see if I can still do this.
Up.
Up. And they're off. I don't know why he's glitching, though.
Let's play Quidditch.
Woo!
Was that the snitch?
So anyway.
Here comes the slithering.
Sorry, I'm gonna have to concentrate here, because... Oh, actually, now that I think about it, I don't think you can actually...
No!
What happened? I don't think you can lose this game. Yeah, I don't think you can lose. Press jump E to catch the snitch. There we go. Oh my god. So many things happening at once. Oh my god, so yeah, please let me talk so I can explain what happened.
Lee Jordan, signing off.
There's so many things happening all at once. There's no time for me to even think about it, anything. Narrator? No? No narrator? So anyway, this is a little bit different than
Harry Potter, the youngest seeker in the history of Hogwarts, had won the Quidditch match.
Yes! Oh my god.
Congratulations again for winning the Quidditch match against Slytherin. You are fantastic!
Thank you.
Something is troubling me, Harry. Ron and I heard strange noises outside the Forbidden Corridor. Come up to the third floor and have a look.
Okay, so oh my god, so many things happening at the same time. So yeah, well, so the Quidditch game is a little bit different from the flying class, because in the flying class you have to go through the hoops, right? In the Quidditch game, you actually just have to go close to the snitch. You see a bar to the lower left side of the screen, and as the closest you are to the actual snitch, the faster you fill up the bar, and then you go to the second phase, which is as soon as the snitch is close to the hand, you just press jump, and Harry collects it. It's very, very simple. Very, 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 very simple. So anyway, we're here now. This is still bugging me, this Folio Magi. But anyway, I think we still have three more Quidditch, two more Quidditch games to play. And if I'm wrong, then maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's like in the storyline, that's just it, and you'll never see Quidditch again. But after the game, we have a Quidditch mini game with an actual cup, like house cup to play. And we're definitely gonna play that as soon as I'm done with the game. Anyway, so you might be wondering, we're here again. Yes, we are, but... There are new things here, so let's explore everything we can before going forward to meet Hermione. Oh, and by the way, guys, this is also something that I've read, that I've seen, that I've watched on the interview. Like all of these paintings here that they put in the game are actually paintings of themselves, like the developers, and they did just like Photoshop them on some like famous paintings that they found, and they just tweaked it a little bit. Like, look at this guy. This guy is definitely one of the developers. You know what I mean? It's so funny. It's so fun to me. I love that. I actually do. Anyway, no secrets. Please don't embarrass me. Here I am saying that we have secrets to uncover, and there's no secrets. Oh, I have people to talk to. Hello, Slytherin.
Hello, Harry.
That's all he has to say for me. How about you, Ravenclaw?
You really do have a lightning bolt scar on your forehead. Lovely day, don't you think? Ron is looking for you. He's on the third floor.
Yeah, but you know, the third floor is forbidden, so he shouldn't even be there. How about you?
Just read in the Daily Prophet that Gringotts, the wizard bank, has been broken into. I wonder who'd do that.
I wonder who would break into the unbreakable bank?
The goblins at Gringotts have claimed that nothing was stolen. I wonder what the thieves were looking for.
Okay, so let's continue forward then. I saw Hermione going to the left, but we're actually going right then. Yeah, because I do not want to miss anything, so let's go. Actually, hold on a minute. No, let's go right. Let's go right and explore. The more wizard cards I have, the better. So we can go up to this place. Hello, girl.
Lovely day, don't you think?
Oh, she's saying the same thing that the other Ravenclaw girl did.
Hello, Harry.
Yep, they're repeating themselves, so... So actually can't do anything with the statue this time. So, excuse me... Am I wrong? Do we not have...
Hello, Harry.
Hello. Hey, you're doing it wrong. I'm the one supposed to be bumping into you.
The third floor is up these stairs. At least it was yesterday.
Oh, okay, so it's up the stairs then.
Those statues are really interesting, don't you think?
Yeah, I've collected all the secrets from them already.
Peeves scares me.
Peeves? Peeves is harmless. Oh. Shit! Peeves! Okay, so we actually have to go up here to the third floor. So that's good. That means I can actively explore the left side here. So, but apparently there's nothing for me to explore. I am embarrassed. Here I was thinking that we have new things to collect, new things to explore, and nope, we don't have anything, just people to talk to.
Please stop that.
But I just want to say hi.
Do I know you?
Excuse me? I'm just the most famous boy your age. Okay, this guy's a little bitch. He doesn't like me. I like how, look, even the students have, like, height difference, and that's so cool.
Please stop that.
Even though they have the same voice. Are you guys twins?
Please stop that.
Okay, fine. Jesus Christ, I'm just asking if you guys are twins. Okay, yeah, so we've come full circle. There's absolutely nothing for me to do. So let's go to the third floor, then. Third floor we go. Oh, Fred and George? Just like Fred and George supposed to appear here. No? Am I wrong? Maybe? Oh, actually, this is a... Oh. Aha! I knew it. There they are. So, they're going straight. So this is actually a big part of the map, actually, now that I remember. We have, like, three places to explore. Left, forward, and right. And I have no idea which one is the one that precedes, that continues the story. But, let's tackle them one place at a time, shall we? So... Now, I know, like, your immediate action is to go forward in order to go to Fred and George, but I actually want to explore a little bit to the left first. I don't want to go too far, though. Just in case it's the way to go, and then there's a cutscene, and then I miss everything.
You really do have a lightning bolt scar on your forehead.
Okay, so all these NPCs are repeating lines from this part of the game. They either go, "Who are you?" or, "Oh, you do have a lightning bolt on your forehead." Yes, yes, I'm the boy who lived, right? I'm Harry Potter.
You're a Gryffindor, aren't you? Well, better than Slytherin, I suppose.
Oh, come on, Hufflepuff! Don't say that!
I won 10 points for Hufflepuff today. We intend to give you Gryffindors a sound thrashing.
Oh my god, this Hufflepuff is... This boy here is so... forceful.
I wish I could be a Seeker.
I won 20 points for Ravenclaw today. We intend to give you Gryffindors a sound thrashing.
You see the bully? You see where the bullying starts? That's the same line of dialogue, but for Hufflepuff, it's just 10 points, but for Ravenclaw, it's 20 points. That's where the bullying for Hufflepuff starts.
Hi, my name is Marilyn. I have a lovely collection of beetle pincers.
Oh, did I just found a named NPC? Marilyn.
Hello, Harry.
And she even has like a different voice. So remember this girl, Marilyn, who loves beetle pincers.
Don't mind Marilyn, she's a bit off.
She does sound kind of like Luna, doesn't she? Luna didn't even exist at this point in time.
Lovely day, don't you think?
Flipendo!
Okay.
Flipendo.
So, Fred and George. I am a little worried because I do not remember if going forward to Fred and George is the way to go or going there is the way to go. Actually, I think going there is the way to go. And it also wraps around to the right side here. So here's what we're gonna do. We're actually gonna... Well, first of all, let's collect this treasure chest first. Yeah. Now we're gonna go over here. Fred. George. What? Where are you guys? I thought I saw you guys coming over here. Ah! You guys are hiding behind this screen, aren't you?
Flipendo.
Oh, you're hiding behind this painting, aren't you? Gnomes? No gnomes? No gnomes. But also no Fred and George. That's interesting. I could swear I saw them going over here. I'm just kidding, guys. So yeah, I'm just joking. It's obviously that they are under the carpet. No. They're here. Hello, Fred. Hello, George.
Hey, Harry.
Hello.
Have you collected 25 beans?
Bro, have I collected 25 beans? Are you serious?
Thanks, Harry. We really needed these. They're for a little joke we're playing on Slytherin. Here's a wizard card for you. You've earned it.
So we've learned...
Come on, George. We've got work to do.
So we've learned that they're using the beans that I've been collecting and giving them to play a prank on the Slytherin students. Interesting. Anyway. Spinny. I also know who this is. Spinny. Explosion. Very important person as well. Oh thank god, here he is. So that means I didn't miss any wizard card. Whew. Oh my god, oh, the nightmares. Anyway, this is number 69. Birdie Bot, 1935 to the present, inventor of Birdie Bot's every flavor beans. Yep, it's this jolly old guy. He's the one who invented all the every flavor beans that we've been collecting. Why did he decide? Well, I guess it's every flavor bean, but why did you have to put like bad tasting beans over there? Know what I mean? Like, why would somebody actively want to eat like a vomit bean? That doesn't make any sense to me. Anyway, let's go right this time and let's talk to these stationary students one last time.
There are secrets everywhere in Hogwarts.
That's true, it's part of the charm.
I cast Flipendo and a dragon statue in the gardens today and found a secret courtyard.
Oh, you did? I've did that 20 more times.
I don't like that snake. It gives me the creeps.
Yeah, snake sure does look like an old bat, doesn't he?
Snape's always awarding points to Slytherin. It's not fair.
That's true. Snape, that's very canon. Snape's always, like, awarding points to...
Excuse me?
To Slytherin students.
I heard a strange growling by the Forbidden Corridor the other day.
Oh, and I'm about to go there. Do you want to go? All right, so if we go here... In this corridor... Goes forward... Oh, but we have a place to go here. Ugh... Okay, so I think that if I go forward... Oh my god, there's so many places to go. Yes, I think if I go forward, I will wrap around on that part I told you guys. And let's not forget this treasure chest over here. So that means this entire section here, this entire room, is a secret place. Or at least, like, not the place I'm supposed to go. But, which means I'm gonna explore it first. I also urgently need a safe book. Otherwise this video is gonna be too long.
Watch out for the venomous tentaculus in the greenhouse. I hear they're dangerous.
They are, they're very dangerous. Hi, Gryffindor girl.
Sorry, but I don't talk to first years.
Oh my god, these guys are so, so rude. I'm even taller than she is, and she's like, don't talk to me, you first year pleb.
You're quite tenacious, aren't you? We're trying to study in here. Do try to be quiet.
It looks to me like you guys are just roaming around and not really studying, but that's just me. Maybe you're just like trying to memorize spells or something. Anything to that extent. Anyway, I'm definitely trying the spell in all of these. What even are those? Bottle shelves? Because I know for a fact that we have a secret here.
Are you? You're Harry Potter.
I am. I'm Harry Potter. Nice to meet you. Pleasure to meet you. But I don't remember which shelf do I have to... Oh, it's probably this one, this obvious one. Well, let's try the not obvious ones first. And then if all else fails, we cast a spell there. Yep. So, welcome over here. And then a flipendo spell here. And woo, down I go. I really like this part. Just for more beans. Up we go, elevator, and finally collect this treasure chest here. Okay, so if my calculations are correct, this place wraps around that other place over there. Yep, it does. So let's collect this. Aha, and that's the way forward to go, probably because of the save book over there. So just to confirm, this place, yep, you see? Then we've wrapped around.
Those gnomes are pesky little things, aren't they?
They are, and I hate them.
I hear Fred and George Weasley trade wizard's cards for beans. I need a Derwent shipping wizard card to complete my set.
Watch out for Peeves, he's a frightful nuisance. Ron is looking for you, he's on the third floor.
It's nice to see like we have like a Slytherin girl talking to two Hufflepuffs. Like it helps to break like the prejudice that's like Slytherins are all like evil people and Hufflepuffs are all dumb people, which is not true in any of those cases. So okay, I am getting tired, so we're definitely gonna need to find music. Oh. If the music stops, you know what it means. Anyway, I was about to say that I definitely need to find a safe book in order for me to stop. This video is getting long! Hello! You die. You die too. Please, you die as well. Oh my god. They're so fast. I see you there, behind the couch. The question is, do we have another one hidden behind any of these furniture? Oh, we do! Look at that! Sneaky little thing. Oh! Get out of here! Oh my god! Oh my god! Wrong one! Okay. Oh. These gnomes, man. These gnomes. They are gonna be the death of me one of these days. Please, let it be a wizard card. It isn't. Just more bees. That's fine. Okay, so I don't think there's anything, like there's no point in trying to cast a spell on all these cupboards or whatever they are, because there's nothing else for us to do here. So, okay, and we're finally done with exploration. Let's save the game. And next time when we come back, we're gonna meet...
Please stop that.
Is that guy telling me to stop Let's Playing? Is that what it is? Please, man. I don't need people like you in my life. All right. But anyway, so next time we continue this game, we're gonna go meet Hermione and Ron going up the stairs to the third floor, because Ron heard growling in the third floor, which is forbidden, by the way. Mystery abounds in Hogwarts! So I will see you guys next time. Ciao!